Hello everyone, this is Hoda Gyeongji. In the last video, we came up with the details of the ceiling. In this video, we're gonna actually draw it in AutoCAD. So if we start from the interior layers, from the inside to the outside, first solid layer is a gypsum board. I don't need to show the airy frame interior. So I'll go with 12.7 for gypsum board. So going from inside to outside, I can offset this line by 12.7. This is going to be my gypsum board. Then we have the polyethylene vapor barrier. So I can change this layer to the vapor barrier layer that I had created before. It's basically just one line with a bit more of a thickness. Next we have the truss bottom cord, which is 38 by 140 or 2 by 6, and they are far from each other by 24 inches. So 38 by 140. And I can copy this by 16 millimeters center to center, gonna be 610. We know that the very last layer is this insulation of cellulose. Go to NRCAN, go to continuous materials, and you can find the cellulose here. And here, if you follow the name of this column, it says the thermal resistance of the material in square meters, degrees Celsius or degrees Kelvin, over what? Over millimeters. That means 1 millimeter of this material provides 0.025, right? So 1 millimeter is 0.025. If I divide this value by 0.025, so 0.025, this is actually 267 millimeters. I can just go with like 268, just round it up. So 268 is the thickness of this layer. I'll go back to my CAD layer. I want to draw one line here, and I want to offset this by 268. So this is actually the amount of cellulose at the top, right, which is 26.8 centimeters, which is actually a lot. And you can also double check it here. In one of the examples that we have here in Appendix A of NRCAN, you see that we have actually the same detail for ceilings below attics. And here you notice that the continuous material for the cellulose is actually 268 millimeters at 0.025 RSI per millimeters, and that's giving us 6.7. So that's the way we did the calculation as well. I can put this note here, and I can kind of put a mark over there, put it here, so we know that this is 268 at 0.025 RSI per millimeters. So this is how we can calculate the thickness. I can also consider this as a reference, so I can put table CM1 for the calculation of the thickness of the material. I can put it as a note for myself or someone else who wants to check this file here, and this is going to be from NRCAN. And because this is in the ceiling, they don't usually put any interior layer over there. and then we can add some text. You can further add dimensions, hatches, notes and everything, and it's gonna look like this.